Today we're talking with Mary Kay Ash from Dallas, Texas. She is founder and chairman of the board of Mary Kay Cosmetics, the 12th fastest growing company in the United States. She's sitting here before me in a beautiful pink ultra suede suit. And we'd like to ask you to begin, Mary Kay. Is pink your favorite color?
Not really. Pink came about in 1963. Everyone had a white bathroom. Mm-hmm. And I was looking for a complementary color for white. And so that delicate shade of pink became the color of the jars, and therefore a pink reputation ensued.
Right. Yes, you mentioned the magic year of 1963, and that was the year you founded your company. And even more interesting is the date that you chose, a date that many of us would feel would be something we'd be superstitious about. And tell us about that.
Well, I guess it would take courage to start a company on Friday the 13th. But it just happened that things fell into place at that moment, and we had to do it on that day, and we really had no trepidation about it. So Richard and I, my son and I, began the company on Friday the 13th, 1963.
And that's been a lucky number for you ever since.
Yes, we consider 13 to be our lucky number now. We're getting ready to build a new corporate office, and it's going to have 13 stories, and we'll be on the 13th floor.
Unlike most hotels that don't even have a 13th
right.
store. Isn't that super? Now, the interesting thing about your career is that you started your company at a time when you were retired, and when a lot of women would be slowing down. You were a grandmother, you wanted to enjoy your grandchildren, and instead you started a company from $5,000 to now almost $500 million in sales. What was the biggest motivating factor behind you lunging into a career that has become a very extraordinary thing in this country?
Well, in 1963, there was no such thing as a liberated woman. You walked two paces behind the boss, and getting into the executive suite was absolutely out of the question. Women were simply not considered for those positions at that point. And since I had trained any number of men for those positions and then found them to be my superior in a few months, I thought, if I can train them, why can't I do that job? And it left me with that little bitter feeling. And so when I retired, I began thinking about writing a book that would help women over some of the obstacles that I had encountered in all those 25 years that I'd worked. And I wrote them all the problems and all of the good things the companies I had been with had done. I got all this on paper, and one day I thought, wouldn't it be great if somebody did this instead of talking about it? Mm-hmm. And so Mary Kay Cosmetics was born. The formulas came from the fact that I had been using this cosmetic since 1953, and the lady who owned the formulations had really never been able to get this off the ground. I always felt that the cosmetic was the best thing I'd ever had on my face. It had done incredible things for me. You know, I'm a great-grandmother.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
16 grandchildren and four great-grandchildren.
Wow. Uh-huh.
And so it had done such great things for me that I felt every woman should share it. But it had gone into obscurity when she died in 61. And so I went out, bought the formulations, put it with my marketing plan that would give women an open-end opportunity, and the objective was to help women over just to do anything they were smart enough to do, really.
Okay.
Because I've always felt that, well, when God made man, he was just practicing.
Now, on your lapel is a beautiful diamond bumblebee, and I know that this bumblebee is a special symbol to you and to the women that you acknowledge for
right.
their outstanding abilities. Tell us about the symbolism.
Well, I'm sure you've read in every airport in America that aerodynamics have proven that the bumblebee's body is too heavy to fly and the wings are too weak, but the bumblebee doesn't know it and it goes right on flying. And I thought, that's perfect. That's just exactly the way women are. They just don't know how great they are and that they really can fly. And so we adopted that as our symbol in very early days. And when a woman in our company reaches the top echelon, the top plateau queen of any of our categories at our annual awards, she's given a diamond bee
mm-hmm.
to, you know, as an award, along with a mink coat and diamond ring and, you know, a few little things
right.
like a pink Cadillac.
Uh-huh. You bet.
Little trivia.
One of the things I know that you built your success on is praise, is
yes.
praising other people. And women need this. Of course, men do too, but there's
uh-huh.
something very, women will walk the extra mile for just a little bit of praise, right?
I absolutely agree. You know, I think that if there was a common denominator among women, in the countries that we're in and in the United States, it's a lack of confidence in their own ability. Mm-hmm. They just don't know how good they are. And if they'll let go and use their innate ability to just do all the things they'd like to do, they can. So lack of confidence. So what we try to do is to praise women to success. We find that most women haven't had a round of applause since they graduated from high school or college, and they're anxious, they're hungry for fulfillment, for self-fulfillment. And we give it to them by praising everything they do and praise them right up the ladder of success.
Mm-hmm. Praise does go a long ways. And of course, you have lots of other incentives that you use, like you mentioned, the pink Cadillacs, right. And they were the first. I guess you got the same color that you use on your bottles, because there hadn't been a pink Cadillac up to that time. Do you still use those today?
Yes, we do. Mm-hmm. We have literally thousands of them now along the nation's highways, mm-hmm. and now we have introduced in the past several years the Regal, the Buick Regal, which is step down from the Cadillac, but or should we say a step toward the Cadillac. Mm-hmm. And on the bumper sticker, you will read, "When I grow up, I'm going to be a Cadillac."
I want you to touch upon the important role that faith has played in your life and in your overall success.
All right. You know, sometimes God does work in very mysterious ways. And when I had put every single penny I had in the world in bottles and jars and cosmetics and formulations, etc., back in 1963, my husband was to have handled the administrative end of our business. I knew nothing of administration, had never had that kind of expertise. 1 month to the day before we were to begin, when he was handling all of those percentages and all the things that go into successful businesses, we were sitting at the breakfast table and he died of a heart attack. Mm. So suddenly I came face to face with the reality of half a business, because I knew nothing of the other half, and when he had talked with me about it, I had not listened, because in my opinion, it was like when a woman's husband is talking to her about the budget, you know, in this ear and out that one, and I didn't listen. So I really didn't know what he had planned, and when God closes the door, he always opens a window, came in the form of my 20-year-old son, who today is president of the company. He earned that position, and when he came in, I have to say I mistrusted God's judgment, because I saw Richard's being able to pick up perhaps boxes I couldn't and fill orders and do things of that sort, but I didn't see him as my husband's replacement. However, today he's recognized from New York to San Francisco as one of the young financial geniuses on the scene, and Richard has definitely earned the position. Mm-hmm. And 5 years after we began the company, he was awarded the American Marketing Association's Man of the Year Award.
Oh, wow.
So he's that's an award, by the way, that's never been given to a man under 50. So he's really quite a person in his own right, and certainly accounts for the administrative financial success of the company.
So faith is number one in your life. We know that you put God first, and
God
then
first,
and then second,
family second, job third.
Right.
And this is what the philosophy that we give everyone who joins our company, and hope that they will keep their lives in the proper perspective and their priorities right. Because it's my opinion that if you make the most money in all the world, and have to go home and count it by yourself, and lose your family in the process.
Right. It's not worth it at all.
It's not worth it.
Right.
No, it isn't.
You know, Mary Kay, as I sit here looking at you, I am reminded of Barbara Cartland, the famous British author, who also is ageless. Have you been likened to her in the past?
That's happened before.
Has it happened before? She is ageless as well. You appear to me to be an ageless lady, and
thank you.
I think all women would love to have that distinction. And in addition to having, you know, I know the outer appearance is very important in terms of beauty, but I know you work at the inner appearance as well.
That's true. I believe that the real beauty comes from within, mm-hmm. and that if we can bring out a woman's inner beauty, all women are beautiful.
Well, you are the greatest advertisement for your own company that I think your company could have.
Thank you.
And it's been a privilege to meet you, Mary Kay Ash, the founder and chairman of the board of Mary Kay Cosmetics. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And this is my quest, to follow that star no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true, to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest, and the world will be better by far, that one man, scorned and covered with scars, still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable stars. God bless you.